Welcome to iLectureOnline. Here we have the same setup we have in the previous video, but now we take a look at the ball. Remember, the density of the ball was less than the density of the liquid inside. And now the question is, as the tube filled with liquid rotates around, which direction will the ball move? And remember that on the last video, we found that the pressure as a function of x was equal to the initial pressure at the beginning plus 1/2, the density of the liquid, times the angle of velocity squared times x squared. In other words, the pressure is a function of x squared, which means the farther you go to the right, the greater the pressure, which means that on the right side of the ball, the pressure is larger, so P is larger on the right side of the ball, and on the left side of the ball, P is smaller. I don't know if you can read that, but there you go. On the right side, the pressure is greater. On the left side, the pressure is smaller. And remember that pressure is equal to force divided by area, which then means that the force is equal to the pressure times area. And of course, the area of both sides of the ball is the same. So where you have the greatest pressure, you will have the greatest force, which means on the right side, since the pressure is larger, you will have a larger force. And I think, is that the pen I want to use? Yep, that is. So here, we have a larger force on the right side, and we have a smaller force on the left side. So F on the right, and we have F on the left. And because the pressure is greater on the right side, therefore the force will be greater on the right side. So the force on the right is going to be greater than the force on the left. And of course, if the force on the right is greater, then the greater force will push the ball to the left, and eventually the ball will end up at the very left side, or the very inner side of the rotation. So on the very left side of the tube, or as the tube goes around, the closest to the axis of rotation. So the ball will simply get pushed to that point right there. It's kind of counterintuitive, because we think as we spin around that things will get pushed to the right, but not in the case where I have an object like a ball that has a smaller or lower density than the density of the liquid. The ball will then get pushed to the left. And that is how we know.